Welcome to our few moments together on the Parsha. This Shabbos, we have the privilege of reading Parshas Vayechi, which ends and completes the entire Chumash Bereishis. And at the end of the Parsha, we're going to say the words Chazak, Chazak, V'nis Chazek. We should be strengthened, continue to be strengthened, and make ourselves even stronger. And as the Gemara in Brachas on Lamed Beis points out, one of the four things that need chizuk, that need strengthening, is Torah. And the reason is because we studied the whole Chumash Bereishis, and we may say to ourselves, I don't know it all. And since I don't know it all, I'll never really learn. I'll never be a Talmud Chacham. I'll never be able to encapsulate and understand all the lessons. So the Torah says, no. Chazak, chazak, v'nis chazek. Strengthen yourself. Just keep learning. You're going to get there. As long as you keep learning, as long as you keep doing, we're going to be better people, and we're going to be more learned, and we're more capable of understanding the depth of Hashem's word. In this week's Sedra, it speaks about the bracha that Yaakov gives to his sons, to the 12 tribes, prior to his taking leave of this world. And he gives each one a blessing that's exceedingly suited directly only to him and to his family. And yet, we know that even though these brachos, these blessings, are directed at a particular shevet, the truth of the matter is, because Klal Yisrael is made up of all the shvatim, each and every individual bracha has import for each and every one of us. We can learn from Yehuda to be a lion when it comes to controlling ourselves and doing the right thing. We can learn from Binyamin to be a ze'ev, a wolf that tears at its prey, meaning that is able to rip away all those things which cause one to stop being in the path of righteousness and to rip away all the fake and false things and to go to the truth. One of the interesting brachos that is given is the one that's given to Yisachar. Now, Yisachar is the one who devoted himself to the study of Torah while his brother Zevulun provided the wherewithal and the means that Yisachar would be able to study the Torah, and Zevulun too learned Torah. But Yisachar was a full-time student, so to speak. He was the one from whom the Yodei Bina Le'itim came out, those who understand and were able to fathom the uniqueness of specific times. Yisachar was the one who sat and learned full-time. Now, when speaking about the bracha of Yisachar, it says, Yisachar chamor gorem. He is a donkey with strong bones who is capable of bearing the burden. And he's rovetz bein ha-mishpesayim. He dwells by the boundaries. All this is very enigmatic and not clear, and we're not going to go into the interpretation of each and every word. I'd like to take a look at the end of the bracha of Yisachar. It says about Yisachar, Vayet shichmo lisbol, he bent his shoulder, so to speak, to bear the burden, Vayehi lemas oved, and he became an indentured eved, an indentured servant. The word mas, of course, meaning tax, and he bore the burden of the taxes, so to speak, of the burden of the servant, of the oved. Now, what does this mean, that he bore the mas of the oved, of the servant? Reb Chanach from Alexander makes a very interesting point. The Gemara in Shabbos, and also on Daf Beis in Megillah, makes a statement about the Aseres Hadibros, the Ten Commandments, that were brought down by Moshe and on Har Sinai. It says over there in the Gemara that every letter, because the luchos that Moshe brought down were through and through, they were me'ever le'ever, from end to end, mize'u u'mize' en k'suvim, they were written from both sides, so the letters penetrated and went through the stone. And the Gemara says, mem v'samech, the letter mem, the end mem, the round, circle, square, mem, and the samach, which is similar to the Mem, if you put those two letters through and through in the stone from one end to the other, the middle part will obviously fall out because it's not being attached to the stone in any way because it went through and through. So the Gemara says, Mem v'samach b'neis hoyu omdim. The letter Mem and the letter Samach were hanging on the Luchos miraculously because the Beis, you know, it was still attached to the stone and the Hey was still attached to the stone. The Aleph, every other letter is attached, the Lamed, through the stone. But when it comes to the Mem and the Samach, they're round or square and the whole, the middle part, would fall out of the stone unless it was being held up miraculously. Says Reb Chanuch from Alexander, Mem v'samach, when the Gemara says, B'neis hoyu omdim, that they stood in the Luchos by miracle, it was telling us about Yisachar. Vayehi lemas oved. He was a servant of Hashem who learned and worked and tried to grow. And when one tries to grow both in learning and in observance, it's almost that it requires a miracle for one to break out of their nature, for one to break through those idiosyncrasies and those personality and character traits which hold us back from being able to be successful. And consequently, the Torah is telling us, Yisachar, when he bent his shoulder to the learning, miracles happened. He became a Talmud Chacham. When a person bends his shoulder to do the right thing and works at it, despite the fact that the Mem and the Samach don't seem to be held up by anything, nevertheless, Lemas Oved, he became like this Mem and Samach that was there miraculously and was capable of being held up in a miraculous fashion. And that's what it means when we say Chazak, Chazak, Venis Chazek. Let us strengthen ourselves that when we try to learn and we think, I'll never be great Talmud Chacham. Or when we try to improve and we say, I can't reach it. You should know, Vayet Shechmo Lizbol, Vayehi Lemas Oved. When you put your shoulder to the grind, miracles happen. Just like the Mem and the Samach were a miracle, so can anyone who tries hard enough can reach their goal miraculously, as the Jewish people have done over all the centuries. Chazak, chazak, v'nis chazek. We are like the miracle of the Mem and the Samach. Have a wonderful Shabbos.